Hi, my name is Amay Kumar. I'm a senior solutions architect with AWS team. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a .NET-based Lambda function to receive events from an IoT button and send to Kinesis data stream. Let's get started. All right, so this is the architecture of the application. We have a Lambda function that's written using C#, and it waits for an IoT button event. Once the IoT button event arrives, it takes the data and sends it to Kinesis data stream. The Kinesis data stream caches the data until it reaches a certain limit. In our example, we are going to configure it for 1 MB. And the Kinesis Firehose picks up the data from Kinesis data stream and throws into S3 bucket. I have an AWS IoT button with me, and this is what I'm going to use in this project. This has you can generate 3 kinds of events with it. One, a single click, just a simple press, and you can do you can get a double click by doing double press, and you can create a long press by pressing long press. So you can easily configure this button to your AWS account. I have it already configured to my AWS account. All right, so we are on the IoT demo project, and this is a Lambda function, and it has one function handler. It receives JSON object as an input, and I'm using Lambda Logger class to log the input so I can actually see the incoming data on CloudWatch. And I'm converting the string to memory stream and using the put records async method from the Amazon Kinesis client class by passing in put records request object and sending it to the Kinesis service. So the put records request object itself has a stream name and records parameters. Stream name is basically the name of the Kinesis stream that we will create next, and records is the data that we are passing to the Kinesis data stream. It's a very simple project, and we are going to deploy it by right-clicking on the solution and clicking Publish to Lambda, Next, and click Upload. That's it. We are on the AWS console, and we are inside the IoT demo API function. You can see that the function is configured to get invoked for an IoT event, and I'm going to click on the AWS IoT trigger point, and you can see that a function has been triggered. All right, so now let's go to the Kinesis homepage. We are at the Kinesis homepage. Let's get started. We're going to create a data stream and a delivery stream. Let's first create a data stream. And remember, we named the data stream as IoT button stream in the Lambda function, so the name has to be exactly the same, so I'm giving it that. And for the number of shards, I'm going to say just 1. That is a simple calculator that you can use if you want to calculate efficiently how many shards you need to use for this data stream. But for demo purposes, I'm just going to use just 1 because we are just dealing with a very small data set. I'm clicking on Create Kinesis Stream. The Kinesis stream is currently being created right now. All right, the IoT button stream has been created. So now let's go create a data firehouse. This is basically the delivery stream that will push the data into an S3 bucket. Let's click on Create Delivery Stream, and this can be anything. I'm going to say IoT delivery stream, and on the source, you can either select a put resource as a Kinesis stream. We already have a Kinesis stream, so we are going to select the existing Kinesis stream, which we just created. Click Next. I'm going to leave all these transformation settings just to the default. Click Next. And the destination, you can select any of these 4 destinations you want. We're going to select Amazon S3. And I already had I had created a specific S3 bucket for this purpose, so I'm selecting AWS stream data, which is the S3 bucket that I had created. You can add a prefix if you want. Click Next. I'm going to change the buffer size to just 1 MB so I can see the results. I'm going to leave everything else as default. And for IAM role, which we need to create, I'm going to click on this. It will take me to the IAM console. You can see that it has populated a default role. I'm going to ask it to create a new policy. You can see the policy document if you want. And I'm going to say allow. You can see that the IAM role has been configured to this to this instance. Click on Next. You can do a quick review and click Create a Delivery Stream. All right, the IoT delivery stream has been successfully created. I went ahead and created a few events on the IoT button. I did a single click, double click, and a few long presses. So let's go to CloudWatch and see if the events have been logged. Remember, we used Lambda Logger to log the events, and we are on CloudWatch. CloudWatch will filter, and we see some events here. And yeah, there you go. There are single clicks, double clicks, and all that. Okay, so it seems the Lambda function is being successfully triggered from the IoT button. Now let's go to S3 and take a look at the S3 bucket and see if the events have arrived. AWS Stream Data is the S3 bucket that we configured. 2018 is the year, month, and the day, and the time. So you see that our process has been successful. So an IoT button triggered an event, and the event got processed by Lambda through the data into Kinesis Data Stream, and it got picked up by Kinesis Data Firehouse, and that was thrown into an S3 bucket. All right, so in this video, we covered how to create a .NET-based Lambda function to receive events from an IoT button and send to Kinesis Data Stream. Hope it helped. Thanks for watching.